Hey, for physics, you said I need the fake law for the last two. I'm pretty sure we only have one fake law.
For each.
Yeah.
Hey, can you go pump
for each one? We have a fake law.
After I do a sentence, I can't.
I don't think we're on 7-5.
Yeah,
I think that's true. And I can't help you with math.
Yeah,
it's time for chemistry.
Well, then I'll just do it on my own. Because I actually need to get this done. Well, I know how to do chemistry.
It's not that. No, it's teaching more. All right. You have chemistry
done? Aurora Hansen, please come to the office. Aurora, please come to the office.
Chemistry.
This is a lot of work rocking.
Chemistry's done? Chemistry was easy.
Wait, you have to go.
I have chemistry.
I didn't even know what we were doing. I was thinking here last time, I still don't know how to do it.
You just have to like.
The stuff we're working on the board? We didn't get through all of it?
I wouldn't know what's going on.
Can we go through the rest of it and turn it in?
That was my plan for today. Because I have to know that you know that, because the next step gets harder. Just like everything else.
Why do I know how to do this?
That's not really
good. Anybody have a clue which one we did last?
I know.
You got pictures of it?
Yeah. Seven.
Wait, yeah.
Who was last?
It was like...
Hannah, were you last?
Was I last?
Were you the last one on the board?
I took a picture of it.
That's not
what it was. Well, I know, but that was the last problem.
I was just hoping that whoever was up there last remembered what problem it was.
It was that one. That was the last one.
That's true. What's that say? In the circle? Yeah. 8?
No.
8A? So we should start with 8B, or do we want to do 8A over again?
Oh, I have it on the right. Let's do 8B. Wait, it's the same one. 8A, 8B are the same.
No, because one of them asked for how much can be produced and you're given moles, and the second one asked for how many grams.
Oh.
So in 8A, your answer should be moles. In 8B, your answer should be grams. 26.4 moles?
Yeah, moles of K2SO4.
Wow. So who wants to come show us how to do 8B? Last time I had to do most of the work.
I can go up there and try, but...
Austin Madison.
Is it not hot?
It's warm.
It's hot.
It's been hotter before.
It's pretty nice though.
I love how nice it is outside.
Don't do that. I saw you walking in with no coat on. I saw you walking in with no coat on as I pulled up.
No, the other one.
That's okay. It's nice though.
That's for you.
Apparently it sucks to be a midget.
What?
You want to know?
Come through!
She's sitting way down there, getting the sun where he did. It was a short joke.
Why is Jesus?
I said it sucks to be a midget. What are you doing anyway? Put the algae away.
Okay.
Are you doing
the
copy?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
let's put it that way.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Don't get me started. I'm getting cranky.
Why are you cranky?
I'm not. Don't get me started.
Hey, my day started out really happy because I actually got a biscuit instead of a croissant. So.
She's retarded.
Oh my god, that is so horrible. How could you possibly live through that?
My day started out bad because I really don't know. I didn't hear anyone.
8 minutes. Somebody go. Thank you for showing up.
I don't even know. We'll try.
Can you give us the given information, the stuff that you can pull out of the problem and say, I know this for sure?
Okay.
That's one of the big keys. We talked about that early.
Okay, I can.
We talked about that early in class, last time.
I wasn't
here.
Hey,
I know that.
What's 7 feet?
1.236. Times 10 to the exponent 22.
Scientific notation?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So we know there's 8.8 moles of FeSO43. We know that we're never going to run out of KOH.
Yeah, I'm dying.
We talked last time about the term limiting reactant. Right?
Yes.
Do you remember what that was? That's the thing that stops you from making more. If we were having a dance competition and you had to have one boy and one girl, how many couples could we make out of the people in this room?
Where's Laddie?
And the limiting reactant would be boys, because that's what you're going to run out of first. That's what a limiting reactant is. That's all.
You should have seen them dance last night. It was pathetic.
Who?
Okay, I watched that on Facebook. I thought they were doing really good.
They were awful.
That's
because what did you just say? You thought they were good?
Yeah,
they sucked. Hey, you wouldn't have done much better.
The big name.
Even if you had a team.
You want to see this video? Image or sign of team.
They suck.
Do I need to come over and twist your ears? Get your head screwed on straight?
This is like half of them on the table.
She reminds me of, like,
yeah.
Her hair.
She's got lots of hair.
It's like Britney's.
It's mine. We have matching hair.
They took a picture of
it. We discussed it at the party.
Yeah. But, like, I could tell, like
what is that?
Yeah, they're trying to be gangster, and some of those girls are just straight white girls, but.
Like, watch. Her,
this is okay.
This is Cheyenne. I don't know who that is, but, like, watch this. This is funny.
This is weird.
I don't know what this is.
I don't know, but they didn't sell it.
What was that? Like,
they just kind of limped their way through that.
That's what Austin has, right? Because that's Zig's girlfriend.
Yeah,
that's funny.
Anybody have a problem with what she put up?
No, but that.
Did she leave anything out?
No.
She didn't leave anything out? She didn't mess anything up? So, how many grams of K2SO4 can we produce? So what are we going to start with and what kind of math are we going to do?
Oh, you put 8.8 in.
Is this one going to be a factored label or a ratio proportion type thing?
Probably factored label. Because you're going to
grams. Okay, so you do like the top.
like this, and then you did like, oh, yeah, but you're going to want to start farther left. You're going to run out of room.
How far is this going?
You're
going
to want to start over. Yeah. That'll work. So, hey, I'm not going to continue to fight for your attention. You have to serious up a little bit. And quit doing the accounting. And quit copy announcement.
Oh, is that PT?
I know. I'm trying to include everybody, not leave anybody out. Don't want anybody to feel picked up.
I do.
You always do, even when I'm not picking on you. So we start with 8.8 moles over
one.
So
in the trash can.
And then what are we going to do with that 8.8 moles?
That's got to cross that out. So this is got to be like
1 mole.
Okay?
Sure. See where we end up.
Okay, so what's this? What are we going to next? What's lower than
I can't see.
What kind of a conversion factor can we use?
That's moles. We just do the same thing. Moles on top.
Moles of what on top?
Grams.
Moles of grams on top?
Or grams of moles of the...
You got to end in grams. You got to convert first.
Oh, so moles of this different thing. Moles of the K2SO4.
There you go.
There are the general.
Honey, you've been gone. So you just told me this,
yes.
We just started this
yes,
call like 3 minutes
ago. Well, no. Don't do that. And go ahead. And we'll erase it. I don't care. Or don't. Erase your one on the bottom. To the right. Just the one. Leave the label.
Okay.
And then put the label in on the top. And we'll worry about labels first and numbers second.
So you want this on here too?
So right now, we're going to convert moles of FeSO43 into what, Laddie?
K12SO4.
K2SO4. So we need moles of K2SO4 on top.
I thought you did like molar mass or something.
Next.
Do you like when that's
so,
a bubble or something?
Take a time out.
It's crazy. We're always just going to use this.
Time out.
Sorry?
No, I asked you a question.
Where's that question?
You tell me if I don't answer your questions or you answer mine.
In step one, we are converting moles of FeSO43 into
that.
Grams.
Moles of K2SO4. Why? Because our answer has to be
grams
of K2SO4. So the first thing we want to do is get our label turned over into this. We have moles, so we have to convert to moles. Where do we get the numbers that go in front of those two labels?
Well, one of them on top of the one, right?
Coefficients.
Yes. Go to the equation, pull out the coefficients. So on the bottom, Hannah has moles of FeSO43, and we should put a?
Two.
Okay, so there should be three right here, right?
Two.
Three?
Wait. FeSO43.
Two.
Two.
FeSO43.
One.
There's
no.
There's a two on that.
The other one
is
two.
Two.
I said two.
You sure?
One. That has an H in it. That's the wrong one. Yeah, this one has
this
a two.
This one has OH.
That
so is that just written incorrectly and needs a two in it?
Yeah.
I have no idea.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That one just needs a two in it. Fe2. So we need this thing? This is what we're talking about. We need that number in front of it.
A one.
We need a one. You were guessing though.
Yeah, but it's a good guess.
And now we know.
Put a three there.
And then we have moles of K2SO43. So we need a three in there.
Mm-hmm.
And that's easy?
Yeah.
What did we do?
You just plugged it in.
In step one, we took the thing that we had, moles of one substance, turned it into moles of the thing that we have to answer. What are we going to do in step two? Because we have moles of the things that we have to answer, but we have to get grams. So here, we're going to turn moles into grams.
Yeah.
And it's still going to be K2SO4. Got that?
Mm-hmm.
Is that going to be hard?
These tables cost a lot.
Put moles on the bottom.
Does that make sense?
It's just going to be more of the where things go.
Yes, but the deal is we're given moles of iron dissolved iron.
I like to feel pretty when I know I'm
so we have to start with that, and then we can turn that into moles of potassium sulfate. And then if we have moles of potassium sulfate, we can turn that into grams of potassium.
Y'all are matching.
That's the deal. What number goes with that?
No, like you haven't seen the rest of the basketball players.
Yeah, that's about three. Okay.
How?
Not for something completely different. Sounds turned over to the other speakers.
So the other speakers, so like...
I had to show a video at the beginning of biology class yesterday.
Of what?
Biology.
I hated biology.
Numbers.
You know what I passed that with?
Yeah, because it's 250.
Hey, Mr. Schroeder, you know what I passed that with? I passed with that, with a bad grade.
Really?
Yeah, I barely passed. I passed with a D plus. Yeah.
He has a really good tone of voice.
Hey, I'm sticking along here too. I'm just learning stuff. Hannah just taught me.
Can we please hold these blinds?
Sure.
I can't see. Very bright.
There's a bunch of children
on
the side.
Why don't you go fix that?
I can't, I stuck with those things.
No, hold it.
Are we ready to move on?
Yeah.
I've been sitting here.
I know.
Did you get a close one? Probably not.
Okay, let's move on so we can like figure this out.
There's as many people with a plus one as there is with a minus one.
Am I one of those plus ones?
What's that mean?
So, with our third factor, We need to do what? Which means we need moles and grams for our labels.
Yeah.
So go put grams in.
Uh-huh.
There's only one place, right? Can we do that?
Why not?
Can we do that?
Yep.
Nope.
You gotta put, don't you put grams
and moles?
Because
grams aren't equal to
the line. No, you put
grams
and moles.
Your grams have to equal up to...
Nope. Don't worry. Anything. You're good. Grams are what?
Oh, like this?
That gram?
No.
Yeah, grams are that. You have to have that. So you can get away with G and then K2SO4. You have to have the chemicals in there because...
Otherwise we don't know.
We started with iron sulfate. We used the equation, which gives us the mole ratio to turn it into moles of K2SO4, and then we turn moles of K2SO4 into grams of K2SO4.
That's
going to
be a 1. Yeah.
Yes. Because these red numbers are grams per mole.
So now we have to find like that thing. What is
yes.
What's it called?
Find the molar mass.
K2SO4 is potassium sulfate.
Oh, gosh.
Okay, it's over there, 19.
You're going to have to write them down and add them together.
Plus 8.
19
plus
16
plus
8. Well, that's one of each.
What?
No, you have to do K times
okay,
2, S, 1 S, and O times 4.
Okay.
And? Do we need that number?
No, you need the, like, these on weight.
Blame
them. You took the wrong stain here. Those aren't right.
Oh!
You need the right ones.
Oh my gosh. There's only 19 on
I didn't tell you that.
You said 19.
I said it was element number 19, yes.
I put like 39.1.
Yes.
Yeah, we're trying to find the teacher for you.
And
then... What's the number?
32.066.
32.1.
15.9994. Remember I told you that's 1, 2, 3, 4? There's 3 9's and a 4.
Can I put 16? Those are... Or I have to put like 15.9.
And wants to round everything to one decimal.
No.
Why? You have to build all of them?
Okay, so just the oxygen is 63.9976. She
didn't write
that down.
Sorry, what? If I would, okay,
99.
I kind of agree with Hannah.
Seven,
rounding to one
seven,
number would be easier to add it and do all that stuff. So.
9976.
What's the actual K?
Hold on. 39.09835.
That's 78.1966.
32.1.
Now just move so I can see the numbers.
Why didn't you put anything in there for all your time figuring that out?
The next part's really easy.
The next part's just multiply, right?
No.
Multiply across.
Yep.
The bottom.
Well, the bottom's obviously going to be like 1.
Or
the
pick.
Yep. Bottom's going to be 1.
So the answer is...
Yeah, you're my pick.
Answer is going to be...
I don't know. I can't do that.
28.8 times 174.260.
765.
No.
26.4.
You multiply.
8.8 times 3.
You multiply.
Times 174.
Hey, what do you think about track?
4, 6.
I think track is track.
It's not.
5. What is it? Did you do it? What is it?
Did you like it?
4,600.
Track hurts.
Yes.
Point.
Track is a contest to see who's got more guts.
4, 6, 9, 2, 8.
Yeah, I'm gonna do it again. Yeah. I should. You know, he used to have me run. I think from the 200 to the 2 mile, I hated it. Cause let's just have him run a 200 right before the 2 mile.
Okay, so it doesn't like that
doing regions.
Yes, it does.
Nope.
You need more cans.
You never ran that relay.
Oh.
Yep. That one and that one. So you have grams and kgs of support, and the walls cancel too. Because this wall and this wall cancel, and this wall and this wall cancel, so you have grams. Everybody's got that?
No, I don't have that.
That's a big number.
Is that the number you have in your work?
I think it's due to this.
Yep.
What's FE?
What?
I'm moving on.
What's FE?
You're too slow. I'm doing it by myself.
I don't know what I
want. What is it?
I have no idea. Where's it at? I said
it
up to the camera.
It's iron,
yeah. Oh, good.
Wait.
I didn't do it for money.
I see lots of people writing stuff down and taking pictures. Does that mean you didn't have that number before you got here today?
I didn't know because I thought it was the same problem. So I was like, oh,
money
is the same one
for me. And? I have a problem with that answer. It's going to be really easy to scribble that down and lose the decimal point, isn't it?
Yeah.
If it had to be like rewritten 5 times by 5 different people, would it still be 4,000.46 at the end?
Maybe.
Guaranteed? Your life depends on it?
No.
Probably not. We need to make that into scientific notation. Can somebody do that?
Times 10 to the...
Times 10 to 2 square.
Yeah.
When you write a number in scientific notation, how do you do it?
Would it be negative 4?
It'd be 4.6 times 10 to the 3rd.
Because it's always one number and then a decimal point, right?
Oh, yeah.
So we would write 4.600469 grams. Time 10 to the 3rd.
Hey, move.
Me?
No, him.
Okay. That's proper scientific notation?
Yeah.
Probably not.
No, you gotta wait. I can't see that.
I just copied all the numbers, I moved the decimal point in. It says 4 point, and then all the numbers are the same. Times 10 to the 3rd, and then grams of K2SO4. So, is scientific notation a new concept?
No.
But that's something that we should do from now on?
How do you know it's for a third?
Because the decimal point belongs there, and I artificially moved it 3 times. So, I've taught this to freshmen 19 times. I'm working on 20 on the other end of the building. When you look at this number, and that's a positive 3, That means that this 4.6 has to get bigger or smaller. If it's a positive number, it has to get bigger. If you have a negative exponent, this 4.6 has to get smaller. So negative means you need to move the decimal this way. Positive means you need to move it to the right. Just like positive and negative in the number line from second grade. So nobody's going to get confused on that? Nobody's going to mess those up?
We already had to do that math.
I should probably ask you for all of your answers to be in both. You have to show your work, so I'm going to see that number, and I'm going to see this as your final answer, right? From now on.
So why did you have to wait 3 times?
Because
of the first decimal?
You absolutely always have one number and then a decimal.
Oh, okay.
So that decimal point just always goes after the first whole number.
So like
that's
for
not
can we leave 8 like that since it's just the small number?
Yes. Numbers over 1,000 should go into scientific.
Well, I just put the next one into scientific, so I will
numbers with a leading zero for a decimal?
What if it's more mass? Does that matter?
No, it doesn't matter what the label is. If the number is bigger than 1,000, or if the first decimal is a zero, it should go into scientific. Now, when you did scientific notation, did you also do significant digits in algebra?
Probably not, since we don't remember.
Bummer. You're going to want to take a minute and go find rules for significant digits. On the internet somewhere. Significant digits or significant figures.
Oh, figures.
It's the
right
same
here.
Darn thing, but two different.
There are three rules, whatever. Non-zero digits or significant. I can't
say that word.
Any zero
digits.
Significant. How do you say that? Significant.
Other.
Significant.
Significant. Just like your boyfriend. Significant other.
A final zero. Or trading zero
with
the decimal portion.
And you should find more than three rules.
I do not know. I'm supposed to set them in. I think. No. Whoa.
Click on the page and go in there. Is there like five?
Yeah.
I think it's five. I haven't done it for almost a year.
Look, I did it.
Well,
I did the next one all by myself.
Good. Smarter than thought, huh?
I did it wrong.
So this one has three.
Is
that
so this one have four significant. So it's going to be
what is tenacity?
Oh my god.
Why is my baby retarded?
Stress it sounds like the operator.
Yeah.
Maddie!
Madison, what causes the problem that you have? Do we have problems with numbers that are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7? Is that going to be a problem to figure out significant digits?
No.
No. There's 7. When do we have a problem with significant digits? When the number has?
Zeros.
There you go. Zeros cause problems with significant digits. The first rule is all non-zero digits are significant, right? What's the second one? All the deals with zeros, right? Madison had one that had like A, B, C, D, had 4 more rules.
Yeah.
Okay. And let's just make them 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we know there's 5 rules. What's the first one?
Zeros plus 4 other digits are not significant. And it says it has a number.
Reading.
Mm-hmm. How many significant digits are in the one that I just wrote?
Well,
that's
staying there. Only two or only four?
Two. I don't know.
It'd be two.
Zero.
Two.
Three. I think it's two or four.
Zero.
Leading zeros are not significant. What is a leading zero?
It's not leading.
We want to put a zero in front.
Where's the leader?
In front.
So zeros in front are not significant.
It's always in front.
Right? That's what that says?
The
one
zero says both the zeros in front.
So this particular number, 0024, has?
Three. Two.
Two significant figures.
You just said
what about 0.0345?
Two. Three.
That's
four. Three more.
That's three. These zeros are out in the front. Do they count?
No. So it doesn't matter if it's
no,
it's
three,
sure
four, five.
Zero.
Is that a rule one or rule two?
Zeros that do nothing but set the decimal point are not significant.
Zeros that do nothing but show you where the decimal is are not significant.
Okay.
Is that the second rule, Madison?
Yeah.
So, in Nikki's terminology that she found, it says set the zero. Do we want to use that? Or does somebody have something better? You know what I mean if I write set the zero? Should help if I use the right word, right? Set the decimal. So does that mean that our three is correct?
Yes.
Those first two zeros are not leading zeros, are they?
I don't know.
That's right.
In number three, those first two zeros show you where the decimal is.
Yeah.
They set the decimal.
And
Nikki just said those are not significant. So that one only has three. What's the next rule?
Trailing zeros.
I don't think they...
So, I write 123,000.
It's all of them.
And it has how many significant zeros? Or significant digits?
Six.
Four.
Six.
Three, four, six.
Six.
Because they're not leading.
They're not in front of zero. Not so you get all of them.
Are those trailing zeros?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You need to have those there. Otherwise, the number would be 123.
Or do those zeros show you where the decimal is?
So
would it be 5
then? No, it's all.
Those zeros are showing you where the decimal is.
The last two.
Okay. This one here is different than that one. These zeros set the decimal. So I'm going to rewrite this one. Over there. So that's another example of the same one. The decimal's after the last zero. Zeros have no value. They don't mean anything. So they're only there to make sure that that decimal point doesn't snap over and show up right there again. Okay? This one is on trailing zeros, so I should change the actual number here. says trailing zeros are not significant. Correct? Mm-hmm. Unless?
Are you sure?
It says that it is.
I think that's number 5.
The ones needed to hold a decimal are significant. That's what I needed to hear.
I have a question. Isn't 0 number 2?
Notice I wrote my example with room to put that in there. Instead of being just enough room for not. Debbie, you asked what?
I thought zeros were being zeros. Like non-zero, zeros, leading zeros, and failing zeros.
Yeah, all of these deal with zeros. So we could put 2A and 2B and 2C and 2D, or we can just number them out.
Sure.
Same thing? Are we okay with this? Trailing zeros are significant. Why are they significant? Would you ever write a number like that?
I'm not.
Why do you even need the zeros?
The only reason anybody would ever put those zeros there is if they're actually measured and we know for sure they're zero.
But there's money.
Okay. Anything that you have actually measured and that you know for sure is significant. Whether it's a zero or a non-zero digit, it doesn't matter. If you've measured it, it's significant. So, do you remember getting story problems? Saying that somebody measured and it was 34.00 inches? And then you had other numbers, and then the tricky part was that you had to have 4 significant digits because it was 34.00 and it was measured? You never had story problems like that before? Okay. You might get tough. And what's our last one?
I hate story problems.
Zeros.
I don't know.
If you're not sure whether a digit is significant, assume that it isn't.
I didn't want to tell the girl on that.
And Madison, your rule says the same thing? Lenny, your last rule says the same thing?
Yeah.
I just got it.
And this is all of the rules we need. So then we should have a couple of examples. And you should figure out how many significant digits these numbers have. Three simple little questions for you. Figure out how many significant digits. Don't say anything.
Like on all, like all together.
Do all three of them. No, individually. Three different answers. And don't say any of them out loud so that everybody else can figure them out. Everybody done? Need another second?
1 second, I'll give up for it.
You want me to answer or you want to do it? First one is? Because?
Zero is a trailing one.
Would that number be there if it wasn't measured?
No.
It wouldn't be there if it wasn't measured. If it's there and it wasn't measured, it's incorrect.
How do you say?
Is that two?
What do you mean?
This one's three.
Yeah. Is it two? Three.
What? One, two, three.
Four, right?
That was right.
And this is what I think ought to be rule number six. Sandwiched zeros are significant. Any zeros that are in between other significant numbers are also significant.
So if it's like 404, then it would be significant?
Yep. 404 has three.
Okay.
00260.001.
Say.
So what would be a five?
You just chop those two off and the rest of them are.
What would be a five?
It's not a zero, so it's significant. Everything that's not a zero is.
What? Why'd you say what would be a five?
Because, like, what numbers would be a five? Like, I'm sure.
Oh, that right there.
Wait, what was number six? Why do you want it for a
second? Science teacher wrote this one. And if I wrote it and I'm a science teacher, it's probably measured.
Oh, is it?
If it's given to you in a problem and there's a point O, it's probably measured. That's the assuming thing.
How do you know if it's not?
It came out of your calculator.
So?
Yeah.
It wasn't given to you in a problem. It showed up in the math from the problem. Then it's probably not. Okay? And, Bree, you got a problem with rule number six?
No.
Okay. Because that's the sandwich rule right there.
That wasn't me.
Okay. These are leading zeros, and these are sandwiched zeros. They're in between other significant
numbers.
What?
So this one has six.
Yeah.
This one has three.
Yeah, but why did you say the? So you just like leave the two zeros out. You want to do it anyway?
Those are not significant. Yeah. Why are significant digits important?
Because they're significant.
How much accuracy were you given in problem number 8B?
A lot.
You were given one number, right?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
What was the most precise digit in that number?
Eight.
Right here, right? Mm-hmm. We have a number that has been measured to 1/10, and our answer goes out to, let's see, thousands, millions, 28 billionths of a gram. Do we have that much precision given to us in the problem? No. That's artificially created precision. You can't have that. This answer should not be reported like that.
Why?
That answer should be reported like this. You should have the same amount of precision in your answer as you do in your problem. Your problem only goes out to tens, so our answer should go to tens. So we should have 4.6 times 10 to the third grams of K2SO4.
Do you want to do that or after that?
That's the proper answer.
So whatever the R.
No. This is new. We're not going backwards. I'm not going to apply this to the stuff you already did.
No, I'm saying, so like whatever, like the 8.8, whatever that's in.
This tells you how many significant digits you're going to have in your answer. Yes. This tells you what kind of precision you're going to have. You're going to go out to the tens place and stop. Got it?
Yeah.
Super hard or not a big deal?
Not a big deal.
Okay. Anybody need a picture of the rules or did you take a picture off your screen?
I was going.
Yeah. If you found them on your screen, just take a picture of your screen, drop it in your chemistry folder, and you can look at it anytime you want.
Good idea. Thank God.
I wouldn't have got off my phone to do it, though.
What?
I would have got my snipping tool to take a picture of my screen.
No, I said thank God for assuming.
Oh.
Hoss, you got it? Okay, so she pressed the bell though. Did you take a picture of that? She's clear over here.
So how many more problems do we have?
That was the last one.
That was it?
No.
Wait, no, B. Oh wait, there's C, but it's like a molar mass thing.
That was
C is easy?
I'm already done with it. I already did it when you guys were.
Okay. So, does anybody need a picture of that? Everybody got it right?
No, I don't get it.
No, I have it.
Are you sure?
Keep it.
I copied you.
No, we're not. Did you?
Duh.
I have no idea. I don't remember anything.
All right, what are we doing in 8C?
What is more mass of this? Iron 2, parentheses SO4. Isn't like molar mass like on there?
Molar mass of?
I know how to do like the
iron 2.
Fe2SO4?
No, we didn't pull up the ship, but.
With 3, yeah, but you're
probably. Yeah, Fe2. That's bad, right? What did you do? Mine is
very low. You gotta put your 2, then parentheses SO4. Or parentheses Fe3.
And we already did that. That was actually on the.
I don't know what it was.
Hey, you wanna know how to do it?
You wanna come do it?
You wanna know how to do it?
Isn't this 174?
I know how to do it.
Pretty sure it's one
friend.
He's ignoring me. Actually, he asked me more before. What if I like get
you right? He's talking about one.
Did everybody get to that?
I'm done.
This is the easiest way to begin that problem.
I did like a graph and I did not do it.
Where did that 3 come from?
I don't know.
Because the 3 on the outside of the parentheses. And then
you take
FE, and then there's 3 times 4.
Right.
Anyway, so you take FE, and then you times it by 2, like the mass of FE.
55847.
It's like vitamins. Gross.
And then you times
out
by
2. Yes, it's 32.066.
26. Like, no, what was it? 8. Was it 26?
It's 15.9.
1, 2, 3,
okay.
4.
And then you put an equal sign.
4, what?
Okay.
Moles of
the. And then your equal sign. Okay, the first one is 111.694. And then the second one is 96.192. And then the third one is 191.99928. And then your entire thing equals 399.8788. And then you do the thingy, and it equals that times 10 to the second. It's 3.9, whatever those numbers are, times 10
okay.
to the second.
So, this one has 5. This one has 5. This one has 6. So, you have to get digits?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10.
So our answer should have?
5.
You should always use the smallest number of significant digits that you were given.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Well, that sucks.
So we're given 5. So our answer should stop there and round off. 399.
I'm not changing mine.
88. Our decimal should move over 2 times, so we should have 3.9988 times 10 to the second.
You said only to do that if it was in the thousands. You lie.
Why you lie?
You're right, I did.
Mm-hmm. You're
such a liar.
Okay.
This is not super complicated.
We are done.
No, we need to be done. So I can do something.
Can you come help me?
Do we need this number?
No.
No.
Was this number in our calculation from the last one? Didn't we have the grams per mole of that same thing, or was it a different thing?
No, it was the K.
It was a different thing.
What?
It was
the
time
I made
like warm.
It was K2SO4.
Okay,
I really like warm.
I knew that was a different number.
I like
the same as what we had before. Problems on your side? If I give you another one just like it with about 20 minutes of class, would you be raising your hand?
Let's just not do that.
I'm not fast enough.
Can we start this next week? Because then I'm. Yeah, can we do that on Tuesday, please? I can't. I'm not
going to
do that.
You messed me up.
I'm a little.
You can give us stuff.
I got a plan.
I got a plan, too.
I know, but I hate your plan. Your plan is always involving naps or goofing around.
A nap. Is
the
purpose
not
just taking
a nap?
Yeah, she does.
No.
Will you come help me with math?
In about 15 minutes.
15 minutes is a long time.
We have 15 minutes of class left. So that'll leave you 10 minutes at the end.
No, we don't.
So we're going to your algebra.
We have like 20.
I have 15 minutes of class left.
Oh,
yeah.
So
we have 20. Which means we do too. This is the point where I need you
to take a nap. All right.
Why? You died.
I love this song. You fun too?
I can't see that song good, but.
Whoa!
Shut the hell up.
Shh.
Shut that door.
see 1 meter wide, which you view from just 1 meter away. Now, every 10 seconds, we will look from 10 times farther away, and our field of view will be 10 times wider. This square is 10 meters wide, and in 10 seconds, the next square will be 10 times as wide. Our picture will center on the pictures, even after they've been lost to sight. 100 meters wide. The distance a man can run in 10 seconds. Cars crowd the highway. Powerboats lie at their docks. The colorful bleachers are soldiers' field. This square is a kilometer wide, 1,000 meters. The distance a racing car can travel in 10 seconds. We see the great city on the lake shore. 10 to the fourth meters, 10 kilometers. The distance a supersonic airplane can travel in 10 seconds. We see first the rounded end of Lake Michigan, then the whole Great Lake. 10 to the fifth meters, the distance an orbiting satellite covers in 10 seconds. Long parades of clouds, the day's weather in the Middle West. 10 to the sixth, a one with six zeros, 1,000,000 meters. Soon the Earth will show as a solid sphere.
What time was that?
We are able to see the Earth now.
No.
Just over a minute.
Massachusetts. I don't know.
It's just but those background stars are so much farther away. They do not yet appear to move. A line extends at the true speed of light. In 1 second, it half crosses the tilted orbit of the moon.
And there goes the...
Now we mark a small part of the path in which the Earth moves about the Sun. Now the orbital paths of the neighbor planets. Venus, then Mars, then Mercury. Entering our field of view is the glowing center of our solar system, the Sun. Followed by the massive outer planets, swinging wide in their big orbits. That outer orbit belongs to Pluto. A fringe of a myriad comets too faint to see completes the solar system. Ten to the 14th. As the solar system shrinks to one bright point in the distance, our sun is plainly now only one among the stars. Looking back from here, we know four southern constellations, still much as they appear, from the far side of the Earth. This square is 10 to the 16th meters, 1 light year, not yet out to the next star.
Oh, wait.
The last 10-second step took us 10 light years further, the next one beyond. My perspective changes so much in each step now that even the background stars will appear within reach. And lastly, it has the bright star objects and some stars in the dark.
Oh my god.
We just got to 100 light years. What's a light year?
I don't even know.
Light year is a distance.
How far light
will travel in a year. The speed of light is what compared to the speed of what's the fastest thing on Earth?
Like just
bullets, maybe?
No.
Huh? That normal people understand?
Electricity.
Compare bullets and the speed of light. Which one's faster?
Light.
Like a little bit or a lot?
A lot.
Yeah, like bullets are in slow motion compared to light. Right?
Yeah.
Is light faster than electricity through a wire?
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is. And you know that you can send a signal through the air to, I don't know where the nearest receiver is, but into our network and out to a satellite and back, and web pages load in like 2 seconds, right? Less than that. And it starts, the signal goes, it comes back, it just doesn't finish because it has to load more than one piece of information. So that one piece of information is like a second all the way out to a satellite and back. And a light year is huge compared to that.
One, but quite unfamiliar stars and clouds of gas surround us as we traverse the Milky Way galaxy.
Yeah.
Giant steps carry us into the outskirts of the galaxy. And as we pull away, we begin to see the great flat spiral facing us. The time and path we chose to leave Chicago has brought us out of the galaxy along a course nearly perpendicular to total satellite galaxies of our own are the clouds of Magellan. 10 to the 22nd power, a million light years. Groups of galaxies bring a new level of structure to the scene.
So we lost the other galaxies?
Moving points are no longer single stars. Whole galaxies of stars, seen as one.
How do we know our question, Austin? Did that answer your question? What? We're going to see whole galaxies.
Was it a bunch of galaxies?
The number on your screen, I stopped it here because?
10 to the 23rd.
Light years.
What do you know that's 10 to the 23rd?
That sounds so brilliant. I
don't know. Somebody asked Brittany.
What?
What do we know that's 10 to the 23rd?
Ooh! Avogadro!
Avogadro's number. 10 to the 23rd, which tells us 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd is the number of?
It's avocado.
That's the number of?
6.022.
I just gave you the number. 6.022 times 10 to the 23rd is the number of?
Avocado.
6.022.
Particles in a mole.
Oh.
Atoms in a mole. Molecules in a mole. Particles in a mole.
Well, yeah, it's avocado.
We passed the big Virgo cluster of galaxies on many others, 100 million light years out. As we approach the limit of our vision, we pause to start
passing.
This lonely scene, the galaxies like dust, is what most of space looks like. This emptiness is normal. The richness of our own neighborhood is the exception.
When the galaxies are gone forever,
the star is reducing the distance of your surface to 1 power of 10 every 2 seconds. In each 2 seconds, we'll appear to cover 90% of the remaining distance back to Earth. Notice the alternation due to great activity and relative inactivity. The rhythm will continue all the way to our next goal, a proton in the nucleus of carbon beneath the skin of the hand of a sleeping man at the picnic.
Can you go faster than
those? He's going 5 times faster.
10 to the 9th meters?
Yeah, how do we know this?
10 to the 8th? Science?
6?
We can test it though, there's too many light years away. We might have to wait for that.
We got the Hubble telescope down, it's called its pulses. Exactly right.
Now how do we get that to
work? 1. We are back at our starting point.
Yeah, sorry.
We slow up at 1 meter.
What's the goal?
Oh my god.
Oh, now we're going into the body.
He said that, but you guys keep talking to me.
I heard it.
I don't think we can go to the
ears.
We are in the domain of universal modules. There are protons and neutrons in every nucleus. from the electrodes in every atom. Atoms bonded to every molecule out to the farthest galaxy.
Certain one or two microscopes.
As a single proton fills our seal, we reach the edge of present understanding.
All right,
well, the soul marks the intense interaction. Our journey has taken us through 40 powers of 10. If now the field is 1 unit, then when we start
the first turn,
it was 10 to the 40th, or 1 and 40 zeros.
It's almost at the end anyway.
20 seconds. No, I don't care.
Hey, he said he was going to go to 40.
He did.
Oh, if you want me to throw it, let's keep playing.
That's 16.
And they were out at positive 25?
Yeah.
25 and 16 is 41. Maybe they stopped at 24. I don't remember. Let me finish, will you? This was made in 1977. In 1977, when I was in, well, I turned 12. I was in fifth grade. The smallest thing in the universe was
an atom.
What are atoms made of?
Molecule.
I get that answer almost every time I ask it.
Protons.
Protons, neutrons, and
electrons.
Which one of those is the smallest?
Electrons.
Electrons. So when I was in fifth grade, the smallest thing in the world, any world,
was an electron.
Was an electron. But since then, we've found things that are smaller. Does anybody have a clue?
Dust. There's a word.
Dust is made of atoms.
Yeah.
Multiple. There's quarks, there's muons, there's leptons, there's bosons. I think I'm probably leaving
one or
two out.
Isn't it like an eon or something?
What's that?
Isn't there something called an eon?
That's a measure of time.
Whatever.
Very funny. So, our knowledge is constantly changing.
Yep.
Our view of the universe is constantly changing thanks to the Hubble telescope and other things. We put a telescope on a rocket and sent it out into space, basically. So, we have math questions. Are your math questions